throughout history, most of manufacturing has been a subtractive process, where you'll take a block of something, either a wood, metal, or ceramic, and you very strategically and technically subtract from it to eventually get your final part. Cold spray is different because it is an additive manufacturing process where you're actually putting layer by layer the particles together and building it up as opposed to subtracting it and removing parts piece by piece. With cold spray, we are blasting particles together at high temperatures and at high speeds in order to get the effective bonds that we want to build the materials. This process presents us an entire new way to be able to build things. Rowan University is leading this exciting $14.5 million research grant that has been given to us by the Department of Defense, specifically the Army Research Labs. The Army Research Labs has pioneered the use of cold spray to repair parts and to sustain DoD assets. At Rowan, we are seeking to move cold spray into different application realms, including the manufacture and repair of polymer composites. Additionally, this type of manufacturing process allows us to then look at parts for civilian use as well. So it can go into the automobile sector, aviation sector, as well as into biomedical applications. We know that cold spray works, and it works well, but we need to really understand why it works for many different types of materials so that we can expand it to even more materials to broaden the application space of where these parts that are made this way can be used. Rowan University will be taking the lead on this research with partners PPG, Drexel University, University of Massachusetts Amherst, and Northeastern University, as well as scientists from the Army Research Labs. By having this state-of-the-art, room-size cold spray system, we are creating a new research ecosystem here on our Glassboro campus. There is nothing else like this in the Mid-Atlantic region, and we know it'll attract a lot of attention from the scientific community, as well as undergraduate and graduate students interested in this type of research. This grant provides us a huge opportunity to make a substantial contribution to a relatively new field and to ultimately transform manufacturing. And that's what we're working on here at Rowan University.